Hello students, how are you? I hope all of you are quite well at home. Students, we have already discussed trial by a court of session, trial of warrant cases by a judicial magistrate, and today we will discuss very important section which can come in between during trial, during inquiry. Now that section 319 of CRPC, very important section. Moreover, today I will tell you that how we are to interpret that section and how the Honorable Supreme Court has interpreted this section. First of all, I have earlier disclosed to you that when you want to understand the authorities, first of all, have command over that particular section. Now, there are these four authorities. Now, these four authorities are on section 319 of CRPC. Now, today we will discuss and we will see that what has been held in this in these authorities and how they have interpreted. First of all, you must understand. I will take back it to you. Now, suppose an FIR has been registered and all of you are well aware that at many times the police department drops the name of particular accused by saying that he has not committed an offense. They drop the name because the accused has been discharged, we can say by them. They are of the opinion that this accused has not committed any offense. Question arises whether they are final authorities to decide. Students, keep in mind, absolutely not. When they present the challan, when they present the police report, the judicial magistrate is not bound to accept as it is. Judicial magistrate can reject that or it can accept. It is his discretion on the basis of documents, material, whether really there is a case against that person or not. Now, section 319 says that if such is the situation, then that accused which has been dropped by that police can be summoned to face the trial by the court. When it appears from evidence. Now here, it will be better, first of all, if I give you one example, so that we will link that example with this and it will be very easy to understand. Now, let us see that there are six persons, A, B, C, D, E, and F. Now, these six persons, they have entered into the house of X. Now, F was having a sword. A, B, C, D, E were having their respective lathis. And they started beating X. Some injuries were caused by F also with his sword. And X became unconscious. His son was there in the house. His wife was also there. They raised hue and cry. Y and Z, two neighbors, have also seen all these persons entering into the house. And they were also having knowledge that A, B, C, D, E were having lathis and F was having sword. Now, thereafter, all the accused ran away when X became unconscious, considering that he is now dead. But immediately, X was removed to the hospital. In the meantime, son of X has registered an FIR that this has happened like this. These accused came and they have caused some injuries on X, and X is admitted in the hospital. In the meantime, the judicial magistrate has also recorded dying declaration of X under section. Now, it was dying declaration because immediately after recording the statement, X died. Now, when the statement has been recorded by the magistrate and X died, that is a very important document. This is known as dying declaration. And in that dying declaration, X has narrated each and everything that A, B, C, D, E were having lathis, F was having sword, and they have caused some injuries. But after recording his statement, he died. Now, this was the case of the prosecution, and the police conducted detailed investigation. And this F, he was son of one MLA, and that MLA was good influence in the area. And somehow they approached the police, and police dropped his name by saying that F was not there, F has not done anything, and F was, his name was dropped by the police. When they prepared the police challan, students keep in mind that in police challan there is column number 2 in which names of those accused are recorded against whom there is nothing on the record. Now they have written name of F in column number 2. Now in Punjab and Haryana we call it Khana number 2. It is very familiar, Khana number 2. We say that this is the person whose name has been given in Khana number 2. Now, Khana number 2 contains those names against which have been discharged by the police. Now, when this police report has been presented, the police has written the name of F in column number 2, and they have held all these 5 persons liable for killing. Now, FIR was written under section 302 of IPC because murder has been committed, person has already died. Y and Z, they have also recorded the statements. Now, this Y, Z and son, their statement tallied. They have narrated the same thing. Not only that, the dying declaration written by that judicial magistrate is also corroborating all the 3 statements. Now, in this way, the police has presented the challan. They have absolved F of all the liabilities, that he has done nothing, he was not there. Now, the question arises whether F can be punished. Now, here this section 319 says that when the session judge will record the evidence during trial, and if in evidence it emerges that F was also there, F had also done something wrong, some crime has been made by him, then he will also be summoned at that stage. Now here, first of all, I will take you people back to those sections of trial that when the, since we have discussed in the class, the trial by a court of session. Now briefly, I will tell you here. Now when the case, when the copies have been supplied to the accused who were present, five accused, thereafter magistrate has committed the case to the court of session, and in court of session, public prosecutor, he has submitted the arguments, counsel, they have also submitted the arguments. Now the stage is that charge has been framed against the accused under section 227, 228, and after framing the charge, the case has been fixed for evidence, and evidence is being recorded under section 231. Now this is the stage as per section 319, that when the session judge will reach this stage, and if he finds that name of this F appears, then he will summon this F and he will also frame the charge against him, and F will also be tried along with other accused. Now this, you have to understand the stage, that when the stage will come. Now I will reiterate that section 319 says that if some accused whose name is not in the list of accused has also committed an offense as per the evidence which has come here, not earlier, which has come here, then he should also be summoned to face the trial, and he should also be jointly tried with the other accused. Now it means the session judge will have to first of all reach this stage to apply section 319, because 319 says that when during evidence, in the course of evidence, in the course of inquiry, trial, if evidence discloses that somebody else was also liable, then that person will also be summoned by the trial court. Now here, the very important question is whether it is the only stage, because that stage, it is very lengthy procedure. It is only the stage, or earlier to that also, the session judge can summon that accused. Now here, we will first of all take that the judicial magistrate has committed the case to the session judge. Section 193 says that session judge can take cognizance now because the case has been committed. Now this controversy has arisen in a case titled as Kishan Singh versus State of Bihar. Two judges were there. Now this case was decided on 11th January 1993. Now in this case, what was the controversy? Whether the session judge has to reach that stage for applying section 319 for the purpose of summoning that additional accused. We may name that additional accused whose name is not in the list of accused. Now, in this authority, what was held? The court held that once a session judge has received the case through commitment order, then the session judge can take cognizance under section 193 before framing the charge against the other accused, other five accused. And the last accused, F, can be summoned at the initial stage, even before framing the charge. Now that section 193 lays down, that session judge can take the cognizance once the case has been committed. Now, in this case, it has been laid down that if the record, if the material collected by the police, if the material on the record itself show that additional accused had also participated in commission of offense, then the additional accused should be summoned at the initial stage under section 193, and he should be summoned and he should also be charged along with other accused in one go, instead of adopting very lengthy procedure. Now, in this case, let us see here. Now, in this case, this F, he was also participating when X became unconscious. Now, son of this X, his statement is there. Y and Z neighbors were there. They had also stated that F was also having his ward. Moreover, judicial magistrate has also recorded dying declaration in which the deceased himself has stated that F was having his ward. He caused some injuries. Thus, there is a sufficient material on the record to summon this accused at the earlier stage without reaching the stage of 390. Now, in this case, it was laid down that in such circumstances like this, the session judge can summon the accused before framing the charge, so that charge may be framed against all the accused jointly. Now, this matter again was controverted before the Honorable Supreme Court, where full bench was there, three judges were there. Now, in this full bench, Honorable Chief Justice of India, former Chief Justice of India, Justice M.M. Punchi was also there. And they have differed from this opinion. And they have laid down that the opinion expressed in this section, in this authority, was not proper. Because such additional accused can only be summoned under section 319 of CPC. He should not be summoned under section 193. Now, once it has been laid down, look here, from 1993 to 1998, all the courts of session judge used to summon additional accused while taking cognizance under section 193 if some material is convincing on the record. But after this authority, the session court stopped taking cognizance under section 193, particularly when there is a mandate of Honorable Supreme Court. Look here, once there is authority of Honorable Supreme Court, we are to follow that authority strictly, meticulously. We cannot go against that order. We are to follow strictly that provision. And the courts had been following this authority since 1998 up to 2013. When again this controversy had come before Honorable Supreme Court, now there were five judges, a constitutional bench was there. Now that constitutional bench was headed by former Honorable Chief Justice of India, Althamas Kabir. And they have laid down that whatever was held in this authority was right one. In Kishan Singh's authority, right decision was made and the accused must be summoned under section 193 if the session judge is of the view that there is a sufficient material on the record. Now, in this authority, it has been made clear that there is no need to wait for that stage. Now, that stage I have already disclosed to you. Which is the stage? First of all, we will come to section 225, 226, 227, then framing of charge 228, then we will read evidence under section 231. Now, it means when the session judge will reach section 231, as per this authority, only then additional accused can be summoned. But in Dharampal and others versus state of Haryana, it was made very clear that session judge is having authority to summon the accused at initial stage when the commitment order has been received. A very interesting point here they have discussed. Now, they also laid down that not only that, if even judicial magistrate on the receipt of police report is of the view that these accused whose name has been given in column number 2 are also liable, have also participated in that offense, now they can also, now this judicial magistrate can also summon them at initial stage before committing the case to the court of session. Now, this was made very clear in Dharampal and other versus state of Haryana authority that even judicial magistrate who is committing the case, he can also summon, he can also take cognizance under section 190 subsection 1 clause B because he is competent. Now, this was made very clear that no doubt, but they have agreed this, that section 319 is still part of the CRPC. Now, it will still come in operation. Now, when it will come in operation, let me disclose to you also. Suppose sufficient material is not on the record, which has been produced by the police, and the record does not show that a particular person whose name is in column number 2 has committed an offense. Now, when there is no sufficient material, then certainly we are to go to that stage when evidence will come. Now, in that case, still 319 will apply. It will still remain as it is. Now, let us see, after this constitutional bench, again, the controversy came before Honorable Supreme Court in another constitutional bench headed by former Honorable Chief Justice of India, P. Sathasivam. And in this authority, the constitutional bench approved what was held in this case. And they have held that the session judge must be allowed to take cognizance under section 193 if he is of the opinion that on the basis of record the accused has committed such offense for which he should be tried again. Now, let me repeat now in a very, now this Kishan Singh versus State of Bihar, 1993, on this date, 11th January 1993. Now, it was laid down that session judge can summon that accused under section 193 on receipt of commitment order. But in this authority, Ranjit Singh versus State of Punjab, they have overruled this view. Now they have laid down that Section 319 should be strictly followed, and there is no earlier stage. Whenever additional accused is to be summoned, he is to be summoned only under Section 319. But in Dharampal and others versus State of Haryana, this authority was overruled and this authority was approved. And similarly, in this constitutional bench also, whatever was held in this constitutional bench, it was approved here. Now, at present, we can say that we are not required to reach this situation 231. We will not now frame the charge under Section 228 against the present accused. And first of all, we are not required to reach this stage 231. Particularly, if some material is on the record that accused had participated in commission of offense, then certainly they can be summoned under Section 193, and the session judge can take cognizance at this stage. Now it means, now the situation, what will be the situation? It means at present, judicial magistrate can also take the cognizance under Section 190 when he has received the challan. But if he has committed, in which some persons are in column number 2, then session judge can also take cognizance under Section 193. But now, if certainly there is no material on the record, then we have to wait Section 231, that when evidence is concluded. Now, briefly we have written here also, that what was held, how authorities were overruled. Now these four authorities are very important on Section 319. Whenever you will read Section 319, first of all, go through that section. Then see all these authorities are on net also, these authorities are available. Then you will understand easily that Section 319 also and these authorities also. Now this is how the students should interpret the law. The students should study, should read the authorities. Now it means, first of all, have full command over that section. Like this case, firstly, I made you people to understand Section 390, then it is very easy for you people to understand all these authorities also. Now, like that, we will continue to discuss multiple authorities. Now, there is no bar on Supreme Court. Honorable Supreme Court can review its decision. Now, how its decision were reviewed by the. Now here, two judges have taken a view. Now it was reviewed by three judges because power of review is with the Honorable Supreme Court. But still, this decision was also reviewed by Honorable Supreme Court in Dharampal and others. Now therefore, we are to keep in mind the latest authorities. What is the latest authority over some? And while delivering lectures, students, I will make you people understand the latest authority over each and every section which we will be reading, and what was the earlier view, what is now view of the Honorable Supreme Court. Yes, students, now we have discussed trials also, trial of warrant case by judicial magistrate, trial of cases by the court of session, and during trial, how a situation arises where a decision is to be made by the trial court. Now, students, I will conclude this lecture here. All the best. Have a good day. Thank you.